Today, we will start a new topic called DFA, state minimization. So, the idea is this: how to construct a DFA for a given language of course for a given regular language such that the DFA contents as few states as possible. So that is what is essentially meant by state minimization. And alongside that, we will also raise the question, given two, let's say, minimal DFAs for the same language, same regular language, are they same essentially? So these two questions we will address in this lecture and in the following few lectures. Okay. So for example, if I consider this language LK, as we have already come across, the set of all binary strings, with the kth last symbol 1. And you know that no DFA with less than 2 power k states can accept LK. Okay. And also, we know a way, a design of a DFA for LK with exactly 2 power k states. Essentially, what I have to do is I remember the last k bits rate, and there are 2 power k, k bit patterns 0, 0, 0, 0, all zeros to all ones. And if a state remembers the last k symbols rate, this LK can be accepted. So this is basically a minimal DFA. Now suppose that using another method, somebody comes up with another DFA with 2 power k states accepting the same language. So are these two DFAs essentially the same? This question is another of importance. We will soon see that yes, they must be same up to something called isomorphism. Okay, which is essentially renaming of the states. Whatever it is, we will slowly but surely look at these two questions with all mathematical details. For now, for this lecture and the next lecture, we will be concerned about how to minimize the state count. And there are actually state count of a DFA. So there are actually two ways. One, throw away all the unreachable states. This is actually an easier part. And the second thing is collapse equivalent states. So these two topics we will investigate today. Now the first one is actually easy and we will see using a simple graph traversal algorithm we can actually throw away all unreachable states. But collapsing equivalent states, so first of all we will ask the question, so what is meant by equivalence? Second, how to collapse? And associated with that, there are several questions. Is the procedure safe? That is, can we still define a DFA with states collapsed in a safe manner? And second question is, safety means, first of all, it is well defined. Second, the language must remain the same. Language of acceptance. And second and third question is, how long shall I or we keep on collapsing? All these issues, one by one, we will address. Okay. So now, let us look at the first question. So, throwing away, discarding all unreachable states. So, here is an example. As you can see, this is an NFA for L2, that is set of all strings W over the binary alphabet, such that the second last symbol is 1. And using a subset construction procedure, so this NFA is fine, right? It keeps on looping on whatever it sees, and at some point of time it makes a non-deterministic guess that it has seen the the second last one, goes to this state, and then whatever it is, 0 or 1, it reads and goes to the accept state. And then if I consider the subset construction procedure, on this NFA, this gives me this DFA. That is on your right side. Okay. So you can see that this part essentially remembers the last two symbols, right? So this is 00. This is essentially, you remember the last two symbols, right, as 01. This is 11. This is 10. Okay. But now you see that this NFA has three states. Okay. So subset construction, this procedure will give me a DFA with 2 power 3, that is 8 states. But we know that only 4 states suffice, 2 power 2 states suffice for accepting this language. In fact, these are these states. This one, this one, this one, and this one. But the subset construction procedure will produce a DFA with 8 states. And as you can see that, if I use a different color, so this state, and this state, they are unreachable. In the sense that, if you start from the start state, then you keep on making state transitions, and question is, irrespective of whatever string appears in the input, you can never reach one of these states, this, 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 or this. Okay. Okay, what did I write here? So it's unreachable. Okay. States. So if I throw these states B, B, C, C, empty set, then the working of the DFA is not at all affected. So this is how I can get rid of 4 useless states. In reality, how can we do it? The procedure is fairly simple. If you look at the state transition diagram, this is basically a graph, directed graph, with possibilities of loops, like this loop. Okay, so forget about that loop. So if you make any, I would say, graph traversal, like DFS or BFS, starting from the start state of the DFA, then at the end of the traversal, the states that are not visited, they cannot be visited, irrespective of all input strings, whatever input string comes. Okay, so you make a graph traversal starting from the start state, and then with impunity you can throw away all unvisited states. This is a fairly straightforward algorithm, and we also know that a BFS or DFS traversal is fairly efficient. So this question is therefore solved. Okay, how to find unreachable states in a, in an efficient manner. And once you find them, you can simply throw them away and you are left with a DFA, which at least has all states which are reachable. Okay, so this is our first, step during the state minimization procedure. So henceforth, because this is a very simple algorithm, I will assume that the DFAs provided to us all come with no unreachable states. Okay, all states are reachable. Still, there is a question of minimizing the number of states. So that is what is by collapsing equivalent states. So before going to the mathematical definitions and playing with this definition and the consequences, I motivate you using an example. So here is this. So this is some DFA with many states, as you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, here 8, 7 plus 8, 15, something like 19. Okay. So if you look at what language it accepts, you can actually work out this accepts all non-empty strings, binary strings, that is strings over the binary alphabet. Such that, let us give it a name X, such that either the length of X is even or the second and the third symbols of X are the same. So I start with a DFA for accepting this language. It is not a particularly good DFA. Deliberately, I have started with a DFA with many states, and in order to explain how this state minimization, that is collapsing of equivalent states, works. Let us see that this works as intended. Empty state, it's not accepted, although its length is even. So this is a reject state. If 0 comes, it comes here. 1 comes, it comes here. So this is still, you'd say, a non-accept state, because the second and third symbols are not yet seen. And if a string of length 1 comes as input, the question of having a second or a third symbol does not make sense. Also, 1, this is of length 1, so this is odd, so this condition is also not satisfied. So I make further branching. When I see 0, 1, 0, 1, okay. So I have this. Now you see that at this level, all strings are of length even, in particular 2. Okay, so these are all accept states. This one is an accept state, this one is an accept state, this one is an accept state, this one is an accept state. Okay. Then what happens? Then, let us see, these are all accept states. Okay, but from this, I have to specify something, some transitions, 0, 1. If it is 0, it comes here. Okay. If it is 0, it comes here. But you see that, in this case, this is 0, this is 0. Okay. So the second symbol and the third symbol are the same. Therefore, the second objective is already fulfilled. Second and third symbols are same. So, the machine now goes to this, I would say, accept state, because its, I would say, objective of the second objective of seeing the second and third symbols to be the same is already fulfilled. Okay, and then whatever comes, it will it will go through this loop. This is the same thing happens if it is 1, 1. So here also, this objective is already fulfilled. So it will simply keep on looping there. Here also, 0, 0, and here, 1, 1. Okay. Otherwise, if it is a situation like 0 followed by 1, 1 followed by 0, 0 followed by 1, or 1 followed by 0, then the second objective is not fulfilled. And this is a level where the length of the string read is odd. So these therefore are reject states. Okay, but the machine has still another way of accepting strings, namely by accepting strings of even length. So if it reads yet another symbol, it comes here. It's an accept state. Like this here, here, and here. Okay. But then if it reads yet another thing, then this is not good. Length of string read so far is 5. So once again it comes to this and rejects. So this is true for this state, this state, this state, and this state. Once again, if another symbol is read, the number of symbols read is 6. So we come here, accept, accept, and this is a loop. Okay. So as I mentioned, I have deliberately introduced many redundant states in order to see how this collapsing can be done. So you start with this. Okay. First of all, you look at this state. Maybe I highlight it using yellow. This state, this state, this state, and this state. So they are all final states. Moreover, whatever the remaining input is, the machine stays in that state. Okay, so this behavior is the same for all of these states, this, 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 and this. So there is no reason for having four states for doing the same job. So these four yellow states, therefore, can be collapsed to a single state with the same behavior. Okay. Now you see that there are further collapsing possibilities. Okay, so now let us look at the remaining states. Maybe this one, I mark by red, this one, and this one. Now these are not final states, but if you see, starting from any of these states, if you read a string of even length, okay, not final, but from this point onward, if you read even number of symbols, you reject, and if you read an odd number of symbols, you accept. Okay. And that behavior is exactly the same in all these red states. Odd, accept, even, reject. Odd, accept, even, reject. Here also, odd, accept, even, reject. Odd, accept, even, reject. Odd, accept, even, reject. Odd, accept, even, reject. Okay. So, they can also be collapsed. But there is a problem. So collapsed means it can be collapsed to a single state. Okay. So I collapse this, and this to a single state. Okay. The next question comes is that, so all these four states have now become only one state. Now, when it sees an input 0, where will it go? It may go here. Okay. So let me use another color. Which one? Maybe yellow and red are done, maybe green. Okay. So if 0 or 1, whatever comes, it will come here. Or it may come here. Or it may come here. Or it may come here. Okay. So if I collapse these four red states, red marked states, where will I put this outward link 0, 1, 2? Okay. Now in this case, it turns out that these green marked states, they are all final. Moreover, they also have a similar thing. If an even number of symbols is read starting from that point, it is accept. If an odd number of symbols are read from that point, the decision is reject. So final, they are all final. Also even means accept. And I would say odd means reject. Okay. So, it turns out that these four states can also be collapsed to a single state. Okay. And then the problem, so these red things are collapsed to a single state, these green things are collapsed to a single state, and now I do not have any problem. So, I have a situation like this. Red, this is reject. And this green, all these are collapsed to a single state. And then I can do this 0, 1 back to 0, 1. Okay. So apparently it seems that we are lucky in this case that this collapse and this collapse are compatible, but soon we will see that there is no luck playing here. This is not a question of luck. This is the rule. If I can collapse this red state, it must be that I will be able to collapse the green states also. Okay. So this is no luck, I would say. This is actually the rule. This is not a stroke of luck. This is the rule. Okay. Formally see what it means. Okay, so that means now all these yellow states can be collapsed to a single state. All these red states can be collapsed to a single state. Likewise, all these green states can be collapsed to a single state. And if I do this, I end up with this. Okay, so essentially, okay, what did I use? That one is green, red, green, and yellow. Okay. So, this is basically my yellow state after collapsing. Okay, so one second, let me see. Green. This is red. So this is basically my collapsed red state, and this is basically my collapsed green state. Okay, good. So now let us see what additional collapse possibilities are there. Okay, so you now see that. Okay, so one thing very important is that although I could collapse this red state, this means I start from here, read one symbol. I will go to here, let's say here. Okay, I come here. Okay, Similarly, if I start from here, I come here. This collapsing criterion is based upon only rejection or acceptance, not in which state it is rejected or accepted. From here, I come here. So this is one accept state. From here, I come here. This is yet another accept state. Okay. So these accept states are not necessarily unique. Okay. But this equivalence is with respect to acceptance and rejection decisions, not with respect to, okay, so not the, or I may write it this way. Exact state where it is rejected or accepted, the reject or accept state, that doesn't matter. Are not important. Okay, they may or may not be the same state, but that is not important. So now let us look at what happens here, whether there exist further reduction possibilities. Now you see that if you start from this state, if you read 0, you end up here. Likewise, if you start from this state, if you read 0, you also end up in this state. Okay. Likewise, if you read 1 from this state, you end up in that red state. Here also, if you read 1, you end up in this state. So that means starting from this, no, I made a mistake, right? 0, you end up. 0, you end up here. 1, you end up here. It's okay. So, I should use this. If you read 1 here, you end up here. Yeah. Now, starting from this state, reading 0 will leave you here, that yellow state. If you start from here, leaving 0 will leave you to this yellow state, same state. Likewise, if I look at 1, if you read 1, you will end up in this red state. Here also, if you read 1, you end up in this state. Okay, red state. So that also implies that henceforth, whatever symbol is red, this will allow the machine to stay in the same state, and same states are definitely equivalent. Therefore, I can also merge this and this. Okay. Yeah. And then you see there is yet another merging possibility at the same level. Maybe I use this color now. So this and this. Okay. If I read 1, I end up here. Here also, if I read 1, I end up in the same state. Here, if I read 0, I end up in this red state. And here also, if I read 0, I end up in this state. So this state and this state can also be collapsed into single state, into a single state. So that gives me a further collapsed thing. So this is the one of these collapsed states, and this is another collapsed state. 0, it comes here. 1, it comes, 0, it comes here. Again, I'm making mistakes. Okay. Okay, so upon 0, it comes here. Upon 1, it comes here. Similarly, from here, upon 0, it comes here. Upon 1, it comes here. Okay. So, this is yet another collapsing. Finally, and if I color these things, maybe just yellow, red, green. Okay. So that was the initial yellow. Then I have this collapsed red state, and I have here this collapsed green state. Okay. And finally, we see that there is a further collapsing possibility. Maybe I use this color. So if I look at this state, if I read 0, I came here. Similarly, if I am in this state, if I read 0, I can come here. Okay, so this is 0, 0. And if I read 1, I come here. Here also, if I read 1, I come here. And therefore, after that, whatever symbol is read, the evolution will be the same. So, these two states can also be collapsed without any problem. Okay, so this is another collapsing possibility. And if I do this, I come up with this. So, this is my new last collapsed state. Maybe I color these things also. It is this collapsed state. It is this collapsed state. And yellow, red, green. Okay. It is yellow, red, and the final collapsed state, this green. Okay. So, of course, the next question is, are there any more collapsing possibilities? Okay, so you look at this DFA and try to answer this. Can you make any further collapsing? But whatever it is, one thing is for certain. Starting from a reasonably huge DFA with these many states, I one by one made sufficient amount of collapsing and eventually ended up in this simple DFA. Okay. Possibly this is not further collapsible. Okay. So, now let us do the maths in order to see how this collapsing works. Okay. So, since we have seven sufficiently many examples, so I start with this definition. Okay. So, I will assume that D is a DFA, and so henceforth I will always assume we have something like this. What is that? Set of states, alphabet, transition function, S and F. Okay, two states, P and Q, are called equivalent. So, this is denoted as P is equivalent to Q. Okay. If for all x in sigma star we have this condition, delta px, sorry, this is delta hat px is in the set of final states if and only if delta hat of qx is in f. So first of all, this must happen for all possible input strings x. So for each such x, if you end up in a final state from p, you must end up in a final state in q, if you start from q. Likewise, if you end up in a non-final state starting from p after consuming x, this must be the same. Starting from q, you consume x and end up in a non-final state. So these two states need not be equal. Delta hat p of px need not be equal to delta hat qx. But if this is a final state, this is a final state. If this is a non-final state, this is a non-final state. Okay. So it is easy to see that this is an equivalence relation on Q. Okay. Why? So starting from P and P, irrespective of whichever X, okay, if P is Q, this is P is definitely P because this and these are basically the same. Therefore, this if and only if condition is true. Also, this definition is symmetric about P and Q. So, if P is equivalent to Q, Q is also equivalent to P. So, this is reflexive, asymmetric and transitive. P, Q and Q is equivalent to R. You can easily see that these two together implies P equivalent to R. So, this is an equivalence relation. Okay, so it's easy to define this equivalence relation. Now, whenever I have equivalence relation, there are equivalence classes. Which we do not like this. Okay, now consider this machine. Okay, so our original machine is this. Okay, now I define a machine D prime, Q prime, same in full alphabet, delta prime will be different, S prime will be different, F set of states will be different. So, starting from this, I define this machine. So this D prime, okay, so I will use a different notation anyway. So Q prime is nothing but the set of all equivalence classes of Q with respect to this. In other words, this is set of all P such that P is in Q. So, you know, equivalence classes partition Q. This is an equivalence partition Q. Now, I can collapse each equivalence class into a single state. Okay. Sigma is same. Start state will be the equivalence class of the start state of the original machine. F prime will be the set of all equivalence classes of final states in original machine D, and delta prime acting on the equivalence class of P, and if you read the symbol A, this is defined as the equivalence class of delta P. Okay, so that completes the description of this machine. So D prime is also often denoted as this. Okay, this is another notation for this. And for Q, this is the same. Okay. So now, what I have achieved is that, so shrinking or collapsing each equivalence class to a single state. Okay. So this is the mathematical description. Okay. Add another page. This is called the quotient construction. Okay. And there are several important things that I need to show. First of all, as is evident from this example, so I want to define something like delta hat of this collapsed state, okay, yellow, okay. And here I have told that this is not the case of luck, this is just a rule, okay. So what does it really mean in this context? In this context, it means that this delta, okay, did I write it correctly? Let me see. Yes, okay. So first of all, I have to show that this is well defined. Okay. So what does it mean? Okay. It means that if take any P and Q which are equivalent, so that we have this, their equivalence classes are same. And you take any input symbol A, then, okay, delta P of A, this implies delta PA will remain equivalent to delta QA. That is, delta, the equivalence class of delta PA is equal to the equivalence class of delta QA. This shows that irrespective of which representative I choose from this equivalent class, is it if it is P or Q, and if I define delta prime this way, so that is, this is nothing but delta prime PA. And this is with respect to this representative P, and here I have delta prime QA. And they are same. Okay, it does not matter which representative P or Q or whatever else I choose to represent the equivalence class. So why this is the case? Okay, so it's given that P is equivalent to Q. Okay. By definition, for all X in sigma star, I am not no longer writing in sigma star. Delta P, delta hat P, X is in F, if and only if delta hat QX is in F. Okay. Now if I write X equal to AY, okay, then what do I write? What do I have? Delta hat of PX is nothing but delta hat of P AY. By definition of delta hat, I have this is delta hat of delta PAY. Okay. And delta hat of QX is similarly delta hat of delta QAY. Okay. Okay, so what does it say? This says that delta hat PA, okay, delta PA after reading Y will go to final state if and only if delta QA after reading Y go to a final state. So this essentially establishes that, and since Y is arbitrary, we can say that delta PA is equivalent to this. Okay, starting from this X, I move to this Y after consuming A, and I can say that they continue to remain equivalent. Therefore, we can safely define this delta hat function this way. Okay, so this is safe. Okay, so this is one thing, and in particular, this can be generalized. I am not doing it, but you can. You can do it fairly straightforward, in a fairly straightforward manner. So, for any string X, delta okay, then string X and for two states P and Q equivalent, we have delta P X, but it is not no longer delta. Delta hat P X will remain equivalent to delta hat Q X. Okay. So for proof, you use induction on the length of X. Okay, and you may have to use this previous result, and therefore I can define delta prime of px. So this is left as an exercise. It's fairly straightforward. You can do it. So it follows, this is an important thing, delta px, the equivalence class of this. Okay. So this is an important thing. Okay. So this is a corollary of this general thing. Okay. Another important thing I need to show is this. P is in F if and only if the equivalence of class is in F prime. So why? This direction, it is obvious. Why it is obvious? So let us look at this previous thing. This is how I have defined, okay, it's not here. So this is how I have defined F prime. Okay, so if P is in F, by definition, the equivalence class of P is in F prime. But what about the converse? Suppose that P is not in F, but this is in F prime. But by definition, this implies this is nothing but Q in F prime for some Q in F, because this is how F prime is defined. Okay. But then this means P is equivalent to Q. But this is already a contradiction, because P is not in F and Q is in F. That is not possible. Okay. For example, if epsilon is read from P, it ends up in a non-final state. Upon reading epsilon from Q, the machine ends up in a final state. And therefore, P and Q cannot be equivalent. P and Q cannot be equivalent. Okay. Fine. So, this leaves us with just one more thing to do. So, final theorem. I say this is the theorem. The language accepted by D is same as the language accepted by D prime. Why? This let me formally work out. So some X belongs to language of D if and only if delta S if and only delta S X is in F. Okay. That is if and only if the equivalence class of delta S X is in F prime. Okay. And this is also same as, this is delta hat. And we have also shown that this is same as the equivalence class of, this is same as the equivalence class of delta SX. No. Delta hat X, sorry, I made a mistake. So what did we show? This is nothing but right. Delta hat of Sx is delta prime hat of starting from Sx, and this implies and is implied by X is in the language of D prime. Okay. So after all this collapsing, we eventually end up in a machine D prime which accepts the same language, exactly the same language as the original machine D prime. So D prime is the collapsed automata. So again, I leave a simple exercise to you. Apply the collapsing procedure again on D prime. That is, you define an equivalence relation on D prime as this if and only if for all x delta hat prime, delta prime hat of p x is in f prime, if and only if delta prime hat qx it is in f prime. Okay, so I am using the single tilde to highlight that this is on d prime. And does it collapse the machine further? So you show that this is not the case. Okay, they're equivalent if and only if they're equal. So now this equivalence relation, this is definitely an equivalence relation, but this is basically an equality relation, and therefore it cannot collapse d prime further. So that's the end of the collapsing procedure. Okay, mathematically at least. Okay, so I think we have just 1 hour done. So let us stop at this point. So in the next class, we will see how we can design an algorithm to compute this collapsed automaton d prime given d. And we will see that it's a fairly straightforward procedure and fairly efficient procedure. Okay, so see you until then. Bye.